the Lord's day. Welcome to God's house this morning. Let's go ahead and stand. Let's praise our Lord, our Savior, our soon coming King. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for your goodness. Lord, we thank you for your majesty, Lord. Lord, we ask that you would meet your people this morning. God, pour your spirit upon each life. Lord, let there be a spirit of repentance. Let there be a spirit of forgiveness, a spirit of love. Lord, draw all men and women near you, Lord, as we give praise, as we honor your name. All the glory belongs to you, God. We thank you. Oh, God, we love you. Yes, God, let him have his way. You came here to magnify him and to tell him how good he is. Amen, amen. And this time, Sister Eric, she's going to lead us home. It's hymns, amen. God bless you, sister.
There is power in the blood. Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood.
Give you rest. Saved our marriage, and you gave us a child, and you gave us this wonderful place to labor. Who are we that, you know, you would call us to labor here in Portland, Oregon? I'm so thankful because yes. God is so good.
Amen. Why don't we all lift our hands up one more time in adoration to God? Begin to count your blessings right now. Begin to think about how God has brought you to the house of God, how He's taken care of you, how He's clothed you, how He's put food on your table, how there's no sickness in your body anymore. Oh God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We praise you, God. Oh God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, Lord. Oh, as you begin to count your blessings, oh, and think about His goodness and His mercy,
yes,
His faithfulness.
Yes.
Thanks be unto God. Oh, Jesus, we love you. Amen, amen. This time, we'd like to wait on you for the Sunday morning tithe and offering. All Christians pay tithe and cheerfully give the offering as unto the Lord. This time, why don't we pray over the gift and the giver? Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your people this morning. God, we ask that you would bless them for their obedience, them trusting you and your word. This time, we'd like to give you back a portion of what you've given us. We thank you, Lord, and we give you the praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. At this time, Sister Everett, She's going to sing a special for us. Let's give God our undivided attention. Let's lift up our hands one more time. As she's working on that, we just got to keep our mind stayed upon Him so we can have that perfect peace because we trust in Him. Oh God, accomplish your eternal will, Lord. Oh God, do it one more time in this service as we surrender to you.
Lord, I surrender my life.
you.
Amen, amen, amen. Praise God. It's a blessing to serve the living God, amen. That he would want us, amen. Praise God. It's good to have everybody in the house of the Lord this morning. Amen. Amen. Hey, Sister Arlene, praise God. Good to see you. Good to see everybody. I'd like to turn your attention to the book of Isaiah, chapter 6. The book of Isaiah, chapter 6, beginning here at verse 1. Had fun with everybody at the picnic Friday. It's a blessing.
Amen.
Good weather. Weather was on our side. Amen. Look forward to doing many more of those. We do have Bible study, of course, Tuesday night, but also fellowship afterwards. It's the first Tuesday of, well, it'll be the first Tuesday of September. So we have fellowship afterwards. A potluck endeavor. Just give us Sister Everett. I don't know what the theme is or if there is a theme, but it's going to be a good time, amen. It's going to be a good time in the Lord. Isaiah chapter 6, beginning here at verse 1. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Above it stood the seraphims. These are the angelic beings. One of the angelic beings. Each one had six wings. With twain he covered his face. He covered his face. With two he covered his face. And with two he covered his feet. And with two he did fly. And one cried unto another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. Yeah. The whole earth is full of his glory. Amen. And the post of the door moved at the voice of him that cried. And the house was filled with smoke. Now imagine this scene right here. This had to be quite the sight to see.
Yes,
sir. Fellas were so loud in there, the post of the temple began to shake, began to move. Probably was a little scared too, wasn't it? Then said I, woe, it's me. For I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips. I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For mine eyes, catch that now, for mine eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. So Isaiah literally saw God. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with the tongs from off the altar. And he laid it upon my mouth and said, Lo, this hath touched thy lips, and thine iniquity is taken away, and thy sin purged. Also I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then said I, Here am I, send me. Help of the Lord, the Holy Ghost, and your help, we want to preach on a message entitled, Here I Am. Here I Am. Sister Everett, if you'll pray for the message messenger, those who are listening this morning.
Loving Lord, we do thank you so much for this privilege and honor just to be here. Lord, to be called by your name, Lord, by your Holy Spirit. Lord, we pray that you would move by the Holy Ghost. And Lord, touch each heart, Lord. Help us to hide your word in our heart. That we would have that here I am spirit in us, Lord.
Yes,
that here I am type of attitude.
Amen.
God, we also ask that you would be with Pastor, Lord. God, allow preaching to be easy, Lord. Allow the words that come out of his mouth to be edifying to your people, God. And allow them to be your words, Lord. Allow him not to add nor take away from what you placed upon his heart. God, give him the boldness to preach, God. Lord,
amen.
We thank you and we ask these things in the matchless name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Here I am. Since its conception, the word of God has come out on top during every campaign. It's faced persecution in every age. Yet the word of God is still victor. I was looking at church history this week and I began to look at Martin Luther and how God used one bold man to start what's known as the Reformation. I even went back a little further and I began to think about how the church was conceived, so to speak, how God used how God used Peter, a fiery, bold preacher, but it would take education to deepen the roots of Christianity, amen. Yes, God used Peter during the day of Pentecost and he preached that bold message, but it would take a man who was more educated in the word of God to deepen the roots, amen. God always is looking for somebody, amen, who's willing to go for him.
Amen.
God has always God always finds men and women who are willing to believe and stand on his word.
Yes.
There's always and will always be people who will go for God. Amen. Amen. And say the words found here in our text verse this morning. Here am I, send me. Yes. Before you and I can be eligible to go for God, and see, we have to and see God as Isaiah saw him. He said he saw him high and lifted up. The crutches have to be removed. Before you and I can go for God and say, here am I, send me, the crutches must be removed. The crutches must be removed. Now I want you to keep in mind that Isaiah had already been a prophet. In chapter 1 of Isaiah, the scriptures tell us plainly he was already a prophet. But God was calling him to go deep. God doesn't want you to just stay the same today. God wants you to go deeper. He wants you to deepen your roots, amen. Isaiah had lived through the last 20 years of Uzziah's reign. The nation was doing quite well on the outward. There was much prosperity in Judah, but there was no corruption. King Uzziah began to reign in Jerusalem at the age of 16, and he reigned for 52 years. The Bible tells us that he did that which was right in the sight of the Lord, according to all that his father Amaziah did. And he sought God in the days of Zechariah, who had understanding in the visions of God. And as long as he sought the Lord, God made him prosper. And folks, that's just it. As long as you seek God, God's going to bless you.
Amen.
As long as you're with God, God's going to be with you.
Amen.
God helped this man, Uzziah, fight his enemies. The Philistines and the Arabians. King Uzziah became a great military leader. The Bible says his name spread far abroad. His name was reaching all the way to the border of Egypt. For he was marvelously helped till he was strong. He was marvelously helped until he was strong. But when he was strong, his heart was lifted up to his destruction. For he transgressed against the Lord his God and went into the temple of the Lord to burn incense unto the altar of incense. And Azariah the priest went in after him, and with him 80 priests of the Lord, 80 priests that were valiant men. And they withstood Uzziah the king and said unto him, it appertaineth not unto thee. That's not for you to do, Uzziah, to burn incense unto the Lord, but the priests of the sons of Aaron that are consecrated to burn incense. Go out of the sanctuary, for thou hast trespassed, neither shall it be for thine honor from the Lord thy God. Church, God will help you until you're strong.
Yes, he will.
God will help you until you get lifted up with pride. As long as Uzziah was with God, God was with him.
Yes.
God was blessing Uzziah on the account of his walk with God. On the account because God wanted to, but also because he was humble.
Come on.
As long as you stay humble and look in your own eyes, God's going to be with you.
Yes, he will.
God's going to help you marvelously. Mm-hmm. You know, there's no bird that flies so high that God can't knock him out of the sky. There's no bird that flies so high that God can't knock him out of the sky. He was marvelously helped until he got lifted up with pride. At the height of his career, he usurped the place of the priest and offered incense. And the priest tried to stop him. Even jacked him up, but he didn't listen. And saints, that's just how pride works.
That's right.
The Bible says Uzziah was wroth and had a censer in his hand to burn incense. And while he was wroth with the priest, the leprosy even rose to his forehead before the priest in the house of the Lord from beside the incense of the altar. Now you think about this man who had all these great things. things going for him and how he just got lifted up. He thought he was a cut above, but really he was a cut beneath. And God began to, and Uzziah began to usurp the office of the priest and just really just jack the priest up. And then God began to lay hands on him and judge him. Now you and I, man, if we look at that, we'll be like, well, God's been me. No, God ain't been me. God wasn't being mean. Mm-mm. Uzziah the king was a leper until the day of his death and dwelt in a separate house. Being a leper in a separated house. He was cut off from the house of the Lord. And Jotham, his son, was over the king's house judging the people of the land. Think about this man that had all these great things going for him. He lost it all in one fell swoop. He lost access to the house of God. You cut off from the house of God, you can't worship God.
That's right.
You can't praise God.
Say it.
You can't even give God an offering.
Say it. Tell it.
What a horrible thing, amen.
Yes.
He was cut off from the house of God. Moreover, he was cut off from his palace. He couldn't even worship. He couldn't even go to his house and get a good night's sleep. Couldn't see his family because he was in an unclean state. He was contagious. He's cut off. A separated house because of pride. Pride, the Bible tells us, go up before destruction. And a haughty spirit before a fall. Pride goes before destruction.
Yes.
The haughty spirit, an arrogant spirit, a know-it-all. Nobody can tell you anything type of spirit. You know more than God.
That's right.
Goes before fall. But aren't you thankful, amen, that we could draw near to God this morning.
Amen.
That we could remove the crutch of pride this morning. Mm-hmm. That we could humble ourselves in his sight this morning.
Yes.
James said it this way, draw near to God and he'll draw near to you. He said, draw nearer. If you get close to God, God will get close to you. Then he says this, cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, ye double-minded. James is a straight shooter, isn't he? He said, you got to cleanse your hands, amen. Not with Irish spring. You need to cleanse your hands, amen, with the blood, amen. We need the blood of Jesus, amen. We need to be stable in our minds, amen. We can't be tossed to and fro, amen. One minute we want to serve God. The other minute we don't, amen. One minute we want to read the Bible. The other minute we don't, amen. One minute we want to pray. The next minute we want to play. We need to be stable individuals today.
Come on, amen.
He said, cleanse your hands. You sinner, stop stealing. Stop touching those women that ain't yours. That woman that ain't yours.
Amen.
Stop touching stuff that you ain't got no business touching.
Amen.
What you touch is really a reflection of what's in the heart. It's really what he's drawing out here. That's why he says purify your heart. Cleanse your heart.
Yes.
You know, a lot of people are trying to get right and get all these things checked out before they come to church. All you need to do is just say, God, I want to make it to heaven today. All you got to do today, amen, is humble yourself and say, God, I need help, amen. God, I want you to cleanse my heart, amen. God, I want some stability in my life, amen. God, I'm tired of being tossed, amen, like a sea, amen. One minute, amen, I'm like that wave, I rise. The next minute, I'm down, amen. I'm tired, amen, of being tossed into the valley of the sin, amen. Like the prophet Elijah of old, how long will you be humble between two opinions? If God be God, follow him. If Baal, follow him. Let me tell you something. As for me and my house, we're going to follow the Lord today.
Amen.
He said, be afflicted and mourn and weep.
Come on.
Your heart needs to be broken. He said, a broken and contrite heart, God will not despise. He'll receive you. A shattered and a contrite heart, a God would not despise. He said, let your laughter be turned to mourning and your joy to heaviness, amen. Be convicted, amen. Don't bypass that conviction, amen. If God is dealing with an area of your life, amen, that means God can help you, amen. That ain't for you to run over that, amen. That's for you to cast your cares upon a true God, amen, that cares for you today.
Amen.
He said, humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord. Think of yourself less. Think of your need for God. He said, humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up.
Yes, he will.
He shall lift you up. He'll lift your countenance. He'll lift your face up, amen. He'll lift your heart up, amen. was, amen. That's called up life, amen. All that wallowing, amen, with the sinners, amen. God will tell you, amen, you can be separate, saith the Lord, amen. And touch not the unclean thing, and I'll be your father, and you'll be my child today.
Amen, amen, amen.
I'm thankful, amen, we got a God that not only, amen, will take us in, amen, and clean us up, but he'll adopt us, amen. He'll bring us into the family of God. He'll give us a family, amen, that cares about us, amen. You got a God, amen. I said you got a God that loves you today.
Yes, 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 Lord.
He don't just abandon us. He calls us his.
That's right.
He makes us joint heirs with Christ. Man, we get the opportunity to say, Abba, Father.
Amen.
We can go to his presence boldly today, amen. We can say, oh, Daddy, I got a need in my life, God. I need you today, God. I need to be clean today, God. I need help in this department of my life, God. I'm struggling in this area of my life, God. God, lift me up today.
Amen, amen.
He said, humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up. During the reign of Uzziah, Judah became prosperous. Like America. America's prosperous. Amen. But what comes with prosperity is pride. It's the tendency to get lifted up. That's why we get tested. That's why God uses temptation, or test rather, to help us stay humble.
Amen.
Now remember, God never tempts with sin.
That's right.
But those tests, amen, a test is designed to draw you near. To get you closer, not to get you bitter.
Amen.
A test, the way God tests, is designed to get you closer in your prayer closet. Not for you to get bitter. Not for you to harden up. Not for you to act like Pharaoh. Not for you to back up, amen. It's for you to draw near. It's for you to say, God, I need you, Daddy. I need you, God. Oh, God, I need you, amen. Oh, no, Satan afflicts me, amen. I know you're coming today. During the reign of Uzziah, Judah became prosperous. Now, remember, keep in mind, Judah's the southern kingdom. The kingdoms had got split up. Northern kingdom was Israel. Judah was the southern kingdom. And so, Judah became prosperous, the southern kingdom. And apparently, Isaiah looked up to him. Some folks say Uzziah was kin to him or what have you. But Isaiah, he really respected King Uzziah's life. You got people like that, don't you? People that you look to, amen. People that you respect. People that you depend on.
Yeah.
Isaiah was like that. He depended on Uzziah in many respects. He depended on him. He respected him. He loved him. He took the king's deaf heart. Think about this. King Uzziah doing his right. There was peace. God had got rid of all his enemies. God was blessing. And so, he didn't know what to think, what to expect. See, it's during times like this where God removes those things and those people that we're dependent on to draw us near. I want you to catch this. It was when Uzziah died that Isaiah saw the Lord. It was when the crutch was removed that Isaiah saw the Lord. It was when the hindrance was removed that Isaiah saw the Lord. If you want to get deeper to God, God said, you got to remove some things. Some things that may be pulling you back. The power of the apostle said it this way, lay aside every weight and every sin that so easily beset you.
Amen.
What's weight, preacher? I think you just think the thing, that thing you're thinking about, that ain't got nothing to do with the message today.
Come on.
He said, remove it. Get rid of that weight. And that sin that so easily beset you, thought you, keeps you from running this race. He said, look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith. Who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despised the shame, and is set down at the right hand of God, amen. He said, that's who you need to be looking to. You need to look to that God, amen, who saved you, amen. You need to look to that God today who started your salvation, amen. You need to look to that God today who's able to finish what he starts.
Yes, yes, yes.
saw the Lord sitting upon the throne, high lifted up, and his train filled the temple. His train. Don't mean he had train tracks, don't mean he was a conductor. The word train, it refers to his robe. His robe filled the temple. He saw God high and lifted up. His train, his robe, filled the temple. Now, back in these days, long robes were regarded as grandeur and majesty. He was a king. God's a king still today. When you see the King of Kings, amen, you'll be in absolute awe, amen. When you see God, I didn't see God with a physical eye like Isaiah did, but I seen God, amen, move in my life. I felt the Holy Ghost in services, amen. I seen God move in the Bible study, amen. I seen God as I read his word, amen, as I prayed to him, amen, as I humbled myself before him. I seen the presence of God today. Man, it's something about feeling his presence.
Amen.
Amen. Just knowing that he's here.
Amen.
Just knowing that he's right here with me.
Yes.
That he's my friend all the way even to the end of the world.
Yes, he is.
And we got a friend that's sticking closer than a brother today.
Amen.
We got a friend that loves us. Amen. That's concerned about us. Mm-hmm. Folks, when the crutches are depending on a man, it's removed. We can see God. Isaiah saw the Lord and heard the angelic creatures worshiping God. They cried one to another, holy, holy, holy. It's the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. Have you said that today, amen? Have you saw God? Have you spent time worshiping your God? Have you seen him, amen? Do you know his character is holy, amen? God has nothing but good and perfect gifts for you today.
Amen.
He's holy. Have you seen your uncleanness? After the crutch was removed, the crutch of man was removed, Isaiah saw the Lord. Then he saw his need for God. Mm-hmm. See, it just don't stop right there. You got to get the crutch removed first. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Then you see God.
Yes.
The sinner can see God move. Huh. All of us saw God, amen, before we got saved, amen. God moved. He drew us by his spirit. We see God, amen, move, amen, upon us, amen, by his spirit, amen. And he brought us to a place, amen, not for us to stay in our sins, amen, not for us to be in an unclean state. He brought us, amen, for us to be holy as he's holy today.
Amen.
Then said I, woe is me, for I am undone. I'm not complete. Because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of people of unclean lips. For mine eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Isaiah said, I'm struck dumb. I'm dumbfounded. You ever been an absolute You ever prayed some time and just like, wow. You ever woke up someday and said, man, I'm saved. I can't believe I'm saved. Remember my wife was talking about that other day. I can't believe this life you've given me. I'm not, you know, a millionaire, whatever the case is. But God, my God is rich in mercy, amen. My God is rich in love, amen. My God is rich in grace today.
Yes, he is.
That's right.
Yes, he is.
And when you see that, you realize, amen, that I don't want for anything, amen. That I got a God that loves me, amen. He's given me people that love me, amen. He's given me fellowship with the heavenly, amen. He's given me access to his grace, amen. He's given me a new God. He's made me a new creature in Christ today. Anybody that has ever been in the presence of the Lord cannot help but see their unclean state. Good is never good enough. God always is working on us, amen.
Yes,
so you always got to deepen your roots as a Christian. Yes. You always got to sharpen the saw, so to speak, amen. As a Christian, amen, you always got to get better, amen. You always got to get bigger, better in God, amen. There's always something to work on, amen. And when Isaiah, I told you before in Isaiah chapter 1, he was a prophet already. He knew God, amen, but God was trying to call him to a different level.
Oh, praise God. Hallelujah.
He was trying to call him deeper. He was telling him to go deep.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the disciples had toiled all night. But Jesus said, cast your nets back out into the deep. Amen. They were used to fishing, but Jesus said, go deeper, amen.
Yeah.
He said, go deeper, amen. He said, go deeper, amen. Don't stay the same today, amen. I know you've toiled all night. I know you're sick and tired, amen. That's why Jesus is telling you to cast your nets in again.
Yeah.
Go deeper. Cast your nets in the deep. Cast your heart into deep. Yes. Trust God with your heart.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. We had a man coming out of the church at our last work. We would visit him, spend time with him. This would endeavor to do with everybody. He would come regularly. But no matter what scriptures you share with him, no matter the messages that were preached, he never thought he was a sinner.
Yeah.
And his mind says he had prayed the sinner's prayer 18, I don't know, I think it was about 50, but he had prayed the sinner's prayer 18 or whatever, I think at a Bible camp. He thought it was right with God. Now I'm not being critical here, no. Please don't lose me on this one. But we would go over to the fella's house. And we're not being nosy when you don't have to invite us in. We're not being nosy when we come by. But the fella would have the Playboys right on the coffee table. But in his mind, he still thought he was right with God. He still thought he was right.
Come on.
Finally, in a service, God opened his eyes and showed him that he was a sinner and in need of his forgiveness. See, the preacher can't open your eyes.
That's right.
The preacher can't open your heart.
That's right.
It takes God.
Yeah. Amen.
It takes a person being willing to receive what God has.
Amen.
That's right.
Instead of having that pitchfork religion, we got to have some personal religion.
Amen.
Every service is personal.
That's right.
Every service is about the individual there. Right. Should be. It's not about sister so-and-so and brother so-and-so. It's about me. Yeah. It's about me drawing near. This is my eternity. Mm-hmm. Amen. My Bible reading is for me.
Yes.
It's my life. God opened his eyes. And don't you know, folks, that joker got so upset he started cursing and swearing in the church. Blankety blank, blankety blank, blankety blank, cuss the preacher out. Cuss me out. Got mad. People get mad with you.
Yeah,
they do. But you got to still be a Christian, don't you? Thanks be to God, and God can help you still be a Christian even when somebody cuss me out.
Thank you.
You know that's God's grace.
Amen.
Every God in heaven, amen, that can help you stay safe. Amen. Amen. Even when somebody do you wrong.
That's right.
Fellow want to fight me and everything.
Oh.
But you know what, though, folks? He was never the same.
Amen.
After that. Yes. God finally showed him that he was in need of his forgiveness. Mm. God finally showed him his unclean state.
Yeah.
Have you seen your uncleanness today? Mm. Have you seen it? The prophet said, I am done because I am a man of unclean lips. Jesus said this in Matthew chapter 15, verse 11. We're almost done. Not that which goeth into the man, the mouth, not that which goeth into the mouth defileth a man, but that which cometh out of the mouth, this defileth a man. It's not what you eat that defiles you. It's what comes out. You can eat pork, you can eat shellfish, you can eat all these things.
Come on now.
That's not what makes you dirty.
Right.
And healthy. But those things which proceeded out of the mouth come from, guess what? The heart. And they defile the man. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, blasphemies. These are the things which defile a man. But to eat with unwashed hands defile not a man. It don't defile you. It may make you sick. It ain't gonna make you filthy in the sight of God, amen. The psalmist said it this way, created me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me, amen. What we need this morning, saints, amen, is not some how-to program, amen. We need a clean heart, amen.
Amen.
Isaiah said, my lips are unclean, and these people I live around have unclean lips too. I need a clean heart. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with the tongs from off the altar. And he laid it upon my mouth and said, lo, this hath touched thy lips, and thy iniquity is taken away, and thy sin purged. It was symbolic, amen, of what Christ can do, amen. He can take your iniquity away. What's iniquity? Crookedness, amen. It's like a rag being wrung out, amen. He can take that away, amen, and make you straight, amen. He can make you all right with God, amen. He can make you his righteous, amen. He can make you his child, amen. God, he can purge your sin away today.
Woo! Amen.
That's right.
That's right.
For us, we can be clean. cleanse this morning, amen, as we go to the altar, amen, of Calvary, if you will, as we present our bodies, a living sacrifice, amen. Jesus, amen, can cleanse us, amen. He can cleanse us with this blood, amen. He'll clean our heart, amen. He'll take our iniquity away, amen. And he'll purge our sins and clean our lips today.
Amen.
And you don't have to try to stop doing a certain habit. All you gotta do is just say, God, help me.
Amen.
Help me, God.
Right.
Help me clean my mouth, amen. Right. Help me clean my thoughts, amen. Oh, God, I need your blood, amen. Don't say, ooh, my bad, amen. Oh, God can take that out of your heart, amen. Just like God took the profanity out of my heart, amen. Just like God took the alcohol out of my heart, amen. Just like God took it all out of my heart. Why? Because his blood is powerful today.
Amen.
There's no other name I know that can clean me up, amen, that can make me into what he wants me to be, amen, that took my old filthy, stinking, wicked mind, amen, and made me new, amen, and made me his son, amen, and made me righteous in his sight.
Praise God. Praise God.
He can make us righteous. Praise God for AA programs and all that. But there ain't nothing like the program of the blood of Jesus, amen. There's nothing, amen. There's no other program I know, amen, that can clean the sinner. The moment, amen, the moment by faith, amen, he'll burn those bridges, amen, to the world, amen. He'll tell you, amen, you can come out from among them and be separate.
Come on. Yes.
God cleans all that. It cleansed out. Really right away, I threw the cigarettes down, amen. I stopped going to the club, amen. The moment I was real serious, amen. Yeah, God was dealing with my heart, amen. But then I surrendered, amen. Then I said, here am I, oh God. I need your forgiveness, amen. Here am I, oh God. I need your love in my life, amen. Here am I, oh God. Tell me about the born again experience today. We need the born again in the spirit. That's the program you need today. We need the love program, amen. I love what Jesus said and what John the Apostle said right here. He said, but if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin.
Amen.
He'll cleanse us from all sin. You just got to know it's sin first. Amen. You may not know it's sin. Amen. And that's fine. Amen. God gives us grace in that department. Amen. But if you know, amen, something's not right in the sight of God, amen, and you're not living the way God will have you to live, amen, if you're not walking in the light, amen, let Jesus, amen, turn you, amen. That's what repent is all about. It ain't about doing a 360, amen. It's about doing a 180 today.
Come on. Come on, man. Come on.
If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Man, folks, there's nothing I know under heaven, amen, that's good as God's program today.
Come on now.
If we confess, as the musician begins to come, if we confess, agree with God about it, don't justify, don't make an excuse for it. Say, God, I grew up like this and all this other junk. Oh, God, that's a part of my character. I can't change it. No. Agree with God about it.
Yeah.
Agree with God. Say, God, you're right. God, I want that for my life, amen. I just don't know how. All you got to do is just start confessing. Not to the preacher, to the high priest, Christ Jesus.
Amen.
We see God, we see the high priest Christ Jesus. He has the name, amen, that you need, amen. He has the program you need today, amen. His word, amen, is settled in heaven and there enough today, amen. It's already settled, amen. It's already a matter of fact, if you will, amen. All you got to do by faith today is come to him boldly.
Amen. Amen.
Once Isaiah got right with God, he heard the voice of the Lord. Crush was removed. He saw his unclean state. Got forgiveness. Then he heard the voice of the Lord. The divine Trinity talking. And he gets wind of it. He's listening in on it. He said, I heard the voice of the Lord say, whom shall I send? And who will, that's plural there, who will go for us? God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost was looking for somebody to go for them.
Yeah.
So I said, God, here I am.
Yes.
God, and when he wouldn't draft it, he volunteered.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
How about it today? Why don't you volunteer for service? As we stand and go before the love of God draws us to say, here I am. How about it? It's a the musician begins to sing, as we begin to pray, as we begin to seek him, come out on faith today. Don't look around. Look within yourself. Close your eyes while you're headed first to God.